My dear students, Assalamu alaikum. Boys and girls of class 11, today we are going to see Biozoology, chapter 11, Chemical Coordination and Integration. So this is Mohideen Ahmed Sharif. Let us start the lesson. So this lesson is all about endocrine glands and hormones, human endocrine system, hypo and hyperactivity of endocrine glands and related disorders, and mechanism of hormone action. So what are all the learning objectives we are going to see in the lesson? First, we will understand the positions of the various endocrine glands and their secretions. Next, we will learn the mechanism of hormone action. Then, to understand the disorders related to hypo and hyperactivity of the endocrine glands. Next, we will learn about the role of gastrointestinal hormones. So students, while hearing your test marks, some may have anxiety and some may hesitate to hear and some may be worried. Do you know the reasons for such immediate changes? While seeing any unexpected happenings, we get goosebumps. Do you know the reason why? These are all due to the biochemical changes happening in our body, which are created by the endocrine system. The above mentioned biochemical changes are due to the hormone adrenaline. It is also called as flight, fright and fight hormone. So first we will start with the endocrine glands and the hormones. So the physiological functions of our human body is regulated and coordinated by both neural and endocrine systems. The endocrine system influences the metabolic activities by means of hormones. So here the hormone means to excite. So these hormones are the chemical messengers related into the blood and circulated as chemical signals and acts specifically on certain organs or tissues called target organs or target tissues. Hormones may speed up or slow down or alter the activity of the target organs. The hormones secreted do not remain permanently in the blood but are converted by the liver into inactive compounds and they are later excreted by the kidneys. So in the picture you can see what are all the endocrine glands and the location of it. So first is the hypothalamus, pineal gland and pituitary gland are located in the brain. Next comes the thoracic region is the thyroid gland. Below that is the thymus gland. And in the kidney there is adrenal gland. Near to that is pancreas. Then ovary is seen in female and testis is seen in the male. So these are the locations of the endocrine glands. So the hormones are chemical messengers because they act as organic catalyst and coenzymes to perform specific functions in the target organs. The target organs contain receptor molecules either on the surface or within the cell. Although different hormones come in contact with cells, only the cells that contain receptor molecules specific for the hormone are physiologically activated. A single hormone may have multiple effects on a single target tissue or on a different target tissues. Many hormones exhibit long-term changes like growth, puberty, and pregnancy. Hormones often influence many organs and organ systems at the same time. Serious deficiency of excess secretion of hormones leads to disorders. Hormones coordinate different physiological and the mental activities. So here, the homeostasis means maintenance of constant internal environment of the body by the different coordinating system. So this is called as the homeostasis. Hormones are composed of water-soluble proteins or peptides or amines or fat-soluble steroids. Now we will see in detail about the human endocrine system. There are two glandular systems such as the exocrine and endocrine glands. The exocrine glands secrete enzyme, saliva and sweat and have ducts to carry their substances to the membrane surfaces. Example, salivary gland and gastric gland. The endocrine glands called ductless glands produce hormones and they lack ducts. They release their hormone to the surrounding tissue fluid. Then the hormone circulates around the body and eventually reach the target organs. So the endocrine glands including the pituitary, parathyroid, pineal, adrenal, thyroid and the thymus gland are also known as exclusive endocrine glands. The hypothalamus along with its neural function also produces hormones and it is considered as a neuroendocrine gland. In addition, several organs such as pancreas, gastrointestinal tract epithelium, kidney, heart, gonads and placenta are also have endocrine tissues and they are known as the parietal endocrine glands. So these are the list of the endocrine glands. And based on the chemical nature of the hormone, the hormones are classified into three classes. One is amines, next one is protein or peptides, and third one is steroids. So in the class amine, the chemical properties are small water soluble derived from tyrosine or tryptophan. Example, adrenaline, noradrenaline, melatonin and thyroid hormone. Then the water soluble hormones are insulin, glucagon and pituitary hormones. The steroids are derived from cholesterol, mostly lipid soluble, and they are found in cortisol, aldosterone, testosterone, estrogen and progesterone. So these are the classes of the hormones. So now we will see about the hypothalamus. So the hypothalamus is a small cone shaped structure that projects downward from the brain ending into the pituitary stalk. In the basal region of the brain, the hypothalamic hypophyseal portal blood vessel connects the hypothalamus and the anterior pituitary. It allows hypothalamic hormones to control anterior pituitary secretion. The posterior pituitary secretion is connected with hypothalamus by a nerve bundle called hypothalamic hypophyseal axis. It produces nerve signal that control the posterior pituitary secretion. Hypothalamus maintains homeostasis, blood pressure, blood temperature, body temperature, cardio fluid electrolyte balance of the body. And now what you are seeing in the picture is the pancreatic gland. So this pancreatic gland is a composite gland which performs both the exocrine and the endocrine functions. It is located just below the stomach as a leaf-like structure. The pancreas is composed of two major tissues, such as the acne and the islet of Langerhans. Acne secretes digestive enzymes, and the islet of Langerhans secrete hormones like insulin and glucagon. Human pancreas have 1 to 2 million islet of Langerhans. In each islet, about 60% cells are beta cells and 25% cells are alpha cells and 10% cells are called as the delta cells. The alpha cells secrete glucagon and the beta cells secrete insulin and the delta cells secrete somatostatin. So the insulin is the major hormone produced by the pancreas. So insulin is a peptide hormone and plays an important role in glucose homeostasis. Its main effect is to lower blood glucose levels by increasing the uptake of glucose into the body cells, especially muscle and fat cells. Insulin also inhibits the breakdown of glycogen to glucose, the conversion of amino acids or fats to glucose. So insulin is rightly called as the hypoglycemic hormone. Here the humulin N. Human insulin is produced by a recombinant DNA technology, genetic engineering, and administered to diabetic patients as injections, not by oral consumption. Reason: because the digestive enzymes tends to digest it. So next one is the action of the adrenal hormones. So the adrenal hormones is secreted by the adrenal gland. So it is called as the flight and the fright hormone. So in general, the function of the adrenal hormones. So glucocorticoids stimulates gluconeogenesis, lipophysis and proteolysis, the life-saving activity. And the cortisol is the, so in the picture you can see about the thyroid stimulating hormones. Okay. So these hormones comes under the pituitary gland and hypophysis. So we know that hypothalamus and pituitary glands are located in the brain, and they are secreting many hormones such as thyrotrophin releasing hormone, gonadotrophin releasing hormone, corticotrophin releasing hormone, growth hormone, prolactin, luteinizing hormone, growth hormone inhibiting hormone, prolactin inhibiting hormone. So like that, they are secreting several hormones. So these follicle stimulating hormones, FSH, is a glycoprotein hormone which regulates the function of the gonads, that is the ovary and the testes. In male, the follicle stimulating hormones along with androgen acts on the germinal epithelium of seminiferous tubules. and they stimulates the production and release of sperms, or it is known as the spermatogenesis. In female, the follicle stimulating hormones acts on the ovaries and brings about the development and maturation of the graafian follicles. So this FSH, mainly it is a glycoprotein hormone which regulates the male and female sex organs. Next is the hormones of the neurohypophysis. So vasopressin or antidiuretic hormone ADH is a peptide hormone which promotes reabsorption of water. So it promotes the reabsorption of the water and electrolytes by distal tubules of nephron, and thereby reduces the loss of water through urine. Hence it is called as the antidiuretic hormone. It also causes constriction of blood vessels when released in large amount and increases the blood pressure. So ADH deficiency causes diabetes insipidus, which includes the production of large amount of urine. Next one is the oxytocin. It is a peptide hormone which stimulates vigorous contraction of the smooth muscles of uterus during the childbirth and the ejection of the milk from the mammary glands. So this pituitary gland is located in a depression in the spinoid bone of a skull below the brain. So it is called hypothalamus. So it is also called as the hypothalamus Sebring. Next we will see about the pineal gland. In human, the pineal gland or epiphysis cerebrae or conarium is located behind the third ventricle of the brain, and it is formed of parenchymal cells and interstitial cells. It secretes the hormone melatonin, which plays a central role in the regulation and rhythm of our body and maintains the normal sleep-wake cycle. In addition, it also regulates the timing of sexual maturation of the gonads. In addition, melatonin also influences metabolism, pigmentation, menstrual cycle and the defense mechanism of our body. So in the picture you can see that thyroid gland, the butterfly shaped thyroid gland is a bilobed gland located below the larynx on each side of the upper trachea. So it's near the neck. It is the largest endocrine gland in the body, and it has two lateral lobes called connected by a median tissue mass called isthmus. Each lobe is made up of many lobules. You can see in the picture. The lobule consists of follicles called acini. So acinus in singular and acini in plural. Each acinus is lined with glandular, cuboidal or squamous epithelial cells. The lumen of acinus is filled with colloid, a thick glycoprotein mixture consisting of thyroglobulin molecules. The hormones of thyroid gland are often called major metabolic hormones. The follicular cells of thyroid gland secrete two hormones, namely triiodothyronine and thyronine or tetraiodothyronine. So, sporadic goiter is a generic disease and it is not caused by iodine or thyroxine deficiency. So, thyroid releasing hormone from the hypothalamus stimulates the adenohypophysis to secrete thyroid stimulating hormone, which in turn stimulates the thyroid gland to secrete the thyroid hormone. So it is follows a negative feedback mechanism. You can see in the picture how that negative feedback mechanism actually functions. So iodine is required from the formation of thyroxine. So to produce this hormone, normal quantities of thyroxine, about 1 mg per week of iodine is required. To To prevent iodine deficiency, common table salt is iodized with 1 part sodium iodide to 1 lakh parts of sodium chloride. So the functions of the thyroid hormone is that it regulates the basal metabolic rate and body heat production. So it stimulates the protein synthesis and promotes the growth. So it is essential for the development of skeletal and the nervous system. Thyroxine plays an important role in maintaining blood pressure. It reduces serum cholesterol levels. Optimum levels of thyroxine in blood is necessary for gonadal functions. So the TCT hormone, that is the thyrocalcitonin, which regulates the blood calcium level and phosphate levels. So the parathyroid hormone, in human 4 tiny parathyroid hormones are found in the posterior wall of the thyroid gland. This gland is composed of 2 types of cells, the Heave cells and the auxiphil cells. The chief cells secrete parathyroid hormone and the functions of auxiphil cells are not known. So the parathyroid hormone or parathormone or PTH is a hypercalcemic hormone. It is a peptide hormone involved in controlling the calcium and phosphate homeostasis. The secretion of PTH is controlled by calcium level in the blood. It increases the blood calcium level by stimulating osteoclasts to dissolve the bone matrix. As a result, calcium and phosphate are released into the blood. So the PTH enhances the reabsorption of calcium and excretion of phosphates by the renal tubules and promotes the activation of vitamin D to increase the calcium absorption by intestinal mucosal cells. So these are the functions of the thyroid and the parathyroid hormone, which are been secreted by the thyroid gland. So which is a bilobed gland located below the larynx on each side of the upper trachea. So now in the picture you are seeing that thymus gland. So the thymus gland is partially an endocrine gland and partially a lymphoid organ. So it is a bilobed structure located just above the heart and the aorta behind the sternum. So it is covered by fibrous capsule and anatomically it is divisible into an outer cortex and an inner medulla. It secretes 4 hormones such as thymolin, thymosin, thymopoietin and thymic humoral factor called as THF. The primary function of the thymus is the production of immunocompetent T lymphocytes, which provides the cell mediated immunity. So students, do you know why the old age people are sick often? Why? Because due to the degeneration of thymus gland, so that the thymocyte level decreases. So as a result, the immunity of the old age people becomes weak and it causes the sickness. So now in the picture you are seeing the adrenal gland. So a pair of adrenal glands are located at the anterior end of the kidneys and Helms also called as the supra-adrenal glands. So anatomically the outer region is the cortex and the inner region is the medulla. So histologically the adrenal cortex has 3 distinct zones called as zona glomerulosa, zona fasciculata and zona reticularis. So zona glomerulosa, you can see in the picture, the thin layer constitute about 50% of adrenal cortex and secretes mineralocorticoids. Zona fasciculata, the middle widest layer, constitutes about 75% of the adrenal cortex and secretes glucocorticoids such as cortisol, corticosterone and trace amounts of adrenal androgen and estrogen. So the zona reticularis, an inner zone of the adrenal cortex, constitutes about 10% of adrenal cortex and secretes the adrenal androgen, raise amount of estrogen and the glucocorticoids. Now we will see about the general functions of the adrenal hormones. So the glucocorticoid stimulates gluconeogenesis, lipolysis and proteolysis, which is the life-saving activity. Cortisol is a glucocorticoid involved in maintaining cardiovascular and kidney functions. It produces anti-inflammatory reactions and suppresses the immune response. It stimulates the red blood cells production. It is also known as stress combat hormone. Mineralocorticoids regulates water and electrolyte balance of our body. Aldosterone stimulates the reabsorption of the sodium and water and eliminates potassium and phosphate ions through excretion. Thus, it helps in maintaining electrolytes and osmotic pressure and blood pressure. So, adrenal androgen play a role in hair growth in the axial region, pubis and the facial and the face region during the puberty. So, the general function of the non-adrenaline is to mobilize the brain and the body for action. Its secretion is less during sleep, more during wakefulness, and reaches much higher levels during the stress situations. This response is known as the fight or flight response. The adrenal medulla secretes the hormone adrenaline and noradrenaline and referred as the 3F hormone. So those are the flight, fight and fright hormone. So adrenaline increases the liver glycogen breakdown into glucose and increases the release of fatty acids from fat cells. During emergency, it increases the heartbeat rate and blood pressure. It stimulates the smooth muscles of cutaneous and visceral arteries to decrease blood flow. It increases blood flow to the skeletal muscles, thereby increases the metabolic rate of the skeletal muscles, cardiac muscles and the nervous tissue, and it is mostly active during the emergency situation. So next we are seeing about the pancreas. So the pancreas is a composite gland which performs both exocrine and endocrine functions. As I have said earlier, so its main function is the production of insulin and glucagon. So the glucagon is a polypeptide hormone. It is a potent hyperglycemic hormone that acts on the liver and promotes the breakdown of glycogen to glucose, which is also called as the glycogenolysis. Synthesis of glucose from lactic acid and non-carbohydrate molecules is called as the gluconeogenesis. Glucagon releases glucose from the liver cells, increasing the blood glucose levels. Since glucagon reduces the cellular uptake and utilization of the glucose, it is called as the hyperglycemic hormone, and insulin is called as the hypoglycemic hormone. So the prolonged hyperglycemia leads to a disorder called as the diabetes mellitus. So do you know that the insulin, the offline period of insulin in plasma is 6 minutes. It is cleared from the circulation within the 10 to 15 minutes. So, dear students, we all know that the endocrine glands control and coordinate the body functions to secreting certain chemical messengers called as hormones. So, due to certain physiological reasons, the blood glucose level of an otherwise normal person. So, can you give the possible cause for the increase in blood glucose level? Find it out and research it. So next we will see about the gonads. So that testes is the male sex part. So a pair of testes is present in the scrotal sacs of males. That testes function as a sex organ and also as an endocrine gland. That testes is composed of seminiferous tubules and interstitial cells or Leydig cells. The Leydig cells secrete several male sex hormones, collectively called androgens, mainly testosterone. So what are the functions of the testosterone? Under the influence of follicle stimulating hormone and luteinizing hormone, testosterone initiates maturation of the male reproductive organ and appearance of secondary sexual characters, muscular growth, growth of facial and axillary hair, masculine voice and male sexual behavior. It enhances the total bone matrix and plays a stimulating role in the process of spermatogenesis, so which is nothing but the production of the sperm cells. Next one is the ovary. So the ovary has a pair of ovaries located in the pelvic region of the abdomen of the female. The ovary is composed of ovarian follicles and the stromal tissues. It produces the eggs or ova. The ovary secretes the steroid hormones estrogen and progesterone. Estrogen is responsible for the maturation of the reproductive organs and development of the secondary sexual characters at puberty. Along with progesterone and estrogens, it promote breast development and initiate the cyclic changes during menstrual cycle. Progesterone prepares the uterus for implantation of the fertilized ovum. It decreases the uterine contraction during pregnancy and stimulates the development of mammary glands and milk secretion. And it is also responsible for the premenstrual changes in the uterus, and it is essential for the formation of the placenta. So students, identify the peaks of follicle stimulating hormone, luteinizing hormone, estrogen and progesterone hormones throughout the menstrual cycle. Urine pregnancy test is done to test the presence of HCG in the urine. So the HCG can be detected in the urine 1 or 2 weeks after the conception. So it acts as an indicator for the pregnancy. So in the picture you can see the location of the major endocrine glands, their secretions and the storage. So it starts from pineal gland, thyroid gland, parathyroid gland, pancreas, ovaries and testes. So in hypothalamus, neurosecretory cells produce hypothalamic releasing and hypothalamic inhibiting hormones. In anterior pituitary gland, thyroid stimulating hormone, prolactin, growth hormone, and gonadotropic hormone are secreted. In posterior pituitary gland, antidiuretic hormone and oxytocin are produced. In thymus gland, it controls the production of the T cells, which is important for immunity. In the adrenal gland, there are adrenal cortex and adrenal medulla. So in adrenal cortex, glucocorticoids and mineralocorticoids are produced, and in adrenal medulla, adrenaline and non-adrenaline is produced to face the stress situations. So the hypothalamus is found deep inside the brain. Its products are releasing and inhibiting hormones and controls the pituitary. Together, the hypothalamus and pituitary control the endocrine glands in our body.